Okay, the next one I want to share with you is to use Google Groups. And to do this, you do have to ask the person on your company or your team who is the administrator to actually go into the administration panel. But to use Google Groups allows you to group your teams into different groups inside of Google, and it makes your permissions much, much easier. And so to get access to that, you'll see here, first we go to the admin panel, and inside the admin panel, we're gonna go down to directory and then groups, and you can see here, I've set up different kinds of groups for the different people that are inside the business. Now, there's two ways of doing groups. One way is to do it the, I'll say the advanced or the complex way, and this makes sense if you've got more than 10 or 15 people in the business or in the organization. And the more advanced way to do it is to have a group for each area of the business. You'll have a group for marketing, group for sales, group for finance, group for executive, and each one of those groups will get access to different resources. If you're working inside your Google Calendar, then inside your Google Calendar, when you share a calendar or you share an event with someone, it's automatically going to share it to everyone in that group when you invite the group. So let me open up TGIT, which is our social hangout here. You can see here that we've invited team at IT Genius, and it's basically going to invite all of the people within that team. It's just automatically going to invite them. And even when new people join the company, we put them in that team and they automatically get invites to all of the events, even the recurring events, for everyone as long as they're a member of the group. And so someone joins the company and they're on the sales team, we just automatically put them in the sales group and they automatically get all the invitations for all the meetings that they need to be a part of. They're going to get the sales meeting, they're going to get the weekly sales retrospective, they're going to get the sales huddle meetings, and then of course they're going to get things like the social hangouts and the all hands and everything because they're a member of the team group. So that is the more complex way of doing it. The simpler way of doing it, if you have a small company, maybe you've got less than 10 people in the organization, is to have just three groups or maybe a fourth one. First group is one called executive or owners. So that's for directors and shareholders and basically anyone who's on the executive of the business. Number two might be managers, if you've got a management layer kind of being set up in the business, or it might be accounts. It might be the finance stuff that just you and your bookkeeper share and you know, collaborate on that. That would be two. And then number three is all team, the whole company. And that's the equivalent of our Team Genius group. And that's basically the one that we put everyone in because then when we invite that group to an event, then absolutely everyone is gonna get access to that group. These groups not only are useful inside of things like calendar, but you can use them to share Google sites, you can use them for chat rooms, and of course you can also use them for Google Drive. Now you might be wondering, well, you know, what's the fourth group, Pete? I did mention a fourth group, and the fourth group is for contractors. So if you have people that are maybe outside the business working with you and you wanna share certain resources with them, then you can put those contractors, even if they're external email addresses, even if they are a Gmail address, you can actually put them into the group, call the group contractors, and then you can share access to whatever you'd like with that. Now, one of the tips that I'm gonna share is how to use shared drives, and shared drives is an advanced feature inside of Google Drive. You do need to be on at least a business standard plan to get access to this, but shared drives allows you to have secure folders for your team and secure folders for people in or out of the business who need access to certain files, and I'll show you in a couple of moments how to actually get all of that set up in just a short while. Okay, so we've got all of that done. That is setting up groups in admin, and let me tell you, it is absolutely phenomenal. Super, 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 super useful. Thank you so much to Regina, who's posted the link there for security. Appreciate that. Awesome, good to have the team supporting me. I appreciate you, Regina. Thank you very much. Okay. So what are we going to go to next? Okay. So next up, we're going to talk about Gmail and specifically chat in Gmail. Now, if you haven't already started using Google Chat, Google has completely rewritten and relaunched in the last year Google Hangouts, or it may even be older than a year now. And this is an absolutely brilliant way of keeping connected with your team with short instant messages. Now, many businesses are using tools like Slack for their internal productivity, but I am strongly against any business using Slack because it's just another one of those tools that you can get subscription fatigue from. And what ends up happening is you have all of your team on Slack. If you're using the free plan right now, what happens is eventually you end up with all of your data in Slack, and there comes a point in time where you want to search for something earlier than the 10,000 message limit, and then all of a sudden, bang, it's gone. You have to pay for your whole team for a paid account, which is I think $50 or $70 a year, just to get access to that one message, so you can have data lost inside there. And Google have effectively ripped off Slack completely, and pretty much every single feature of Slack is available here. You've got rooms, you've got threads, you've got plugins, you've got bots, you've got guest access, which wasn't enabled when it first launched. So you've got absolutely everything that you need here to replace Slack with Google Chat. Now, that's not what I'm sharing with you, why it's important to be using it. What I am sharing is that it's actually important to have that switched on inside of Gmail. So this is something you need to do inside the administrator panel. So you'll have to ask the admin of your company to do it. But here you'll see I've got not only my instant messages and my direct messages, but also all of the rooms here as well. So effectively, I can have a conversation open here, just kind of like sits down in the bottom of my window here. So if I'm doing emails or if I'm, you know, working productively on other things, I can jump straight into chat anytime I need to. Pretty cool feature, huh? It's absolutely cool. And if you haven't yet enabled that, it is in the admin panel under your Gmail settings. Okay. The next one I want to take you through is setting up your calendar properly. And so inside your calendar, you actually have the feature and the ability to set your working hours and to set out of office hours as well. And so inside my calendar, if I go to my settings, I'm going to open up my settings here. I can set my work hours. So let me open up here. You can see I've just put Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And that basically warns anyone who's trying to schedule a meeting with me outside of those hours that they are outside my work hours. It'll pop up a little warning and just kind of let people know. The other feature that I really love, which is a new feature that not many people know about, is the ability to set an out-of-office day. And so let's say I'm on a week of annual leave, and right now Regina is on annual leave, but let's say next Friday I don't want to do any work in the business. I can click on the all-day box here. I just click on the all-day box up the top, and then I click out-of-office. And you'll see here there's a tick box, automatically decline new and existing meetings. What this is going to do is it's going to automatically decline any meeting that pops up on my calendar. And it's also going to let people know that I'm out of the office. So see, all those meetings that I was invited to, it actually went ahead and declined those automatically, which is really cool. Now, not only is that useful because it just makes your calendar kind of like clean and easy, but the thing that I absolutely love about this is anytime I try and interact with a team member who's on leave, and that might be Regina who's currently on leave, I can actually, as I open a personal message to Regina, I can actually see that down here, Regina is out of the office. And so if you've got a large team, you can kind of start to lose track of like who's in today, who's out today, someone's on leave, someone's sick or whatever. But if people actually put, I'm literally out of the office today on their calendar, then anytime you go to either send them an instant message or get this, or even writing an email to that person. I'm just going to open my email and make sure this email is not sensitive before I go and email it. No, that one is sensitive, so I'm not going to do it. but when you go and email it, you'll see the same little warning down the bottom before emailing a person saying, hey, this person is out of the office. Just so you know, you don't need to expect a response. And it even tells you when they're coming back as well. So that's yet another reason that it makes sense to use all of the Google's tools for this. Because if you're in a third-party tool, Slack doesn't know if you're out of the office or not. It just doesn't have any integration with the rest of the bits and pieces there. So those are the things that you should really have set up to make sure your Google Workspace is absolutely killer. I want to take you through some of the most important things that you need to know if you're an administrator of a Google account. And if you're a business owner, you are most likely going to be the admin for the account. If you set it up yourself, you will definitely be the admin if you created your account first. If someone else is currently the owner of your Google account, or you bought it through a reseller and they never made them the admin, then you have the right to request to be made an admin for your account. Now, when you are an admin, you actually get access to something called the admin panel, and that is effectively a console where you can manage everything there is to manage with your Google account, adding and removing users, creating groups, and everything else that you need to fully administer your Google account. I'm just going to sign in here and show you mine in the background as I'm talking. You can see I've got all the different areas of Google that I can manage. And so I've got users, I've got groups, organizational units, and we're not going to go through every single one of these, but I'm going to show you some of the most critical things that you can do if you're an admin on the account, and that will help you to get you and your team running better, running smoother, and getting the most out of your investment of Google. Because we want you to use all of the features and all the tools. You're paying your good money to Google, so let's make sure you get everything that you should be getting out of it. Now, how do you access the admin panel? Super simple. You head along to admin.google.com. And if you have any trouble accessing it, like if there's any warnings or anything that pop up, you may not have access to the admin panel. And so you need to check that you're a super administrator, check with your reseller, And if you have any trouble with that, you can, of course, get in touch with our team. Head along to itgenius.com and we'll be able to help that out for you.